Stephen, congrats on an amazing hosting job tonight. How do you feel?
Well, I need to sit down. My legs have gone. I've been standing up so long. It's terrific. What a great night.
Absolutely.
You know, it's just 20 people who've just won a BAFTA, and that doesn't happen very often in someone's life. So, you know, just it's very exciting to be there and see them come up. And some people genuinely just gobsmacked. Really, you could see they just weren't expecting it, and it's kind of amazing to see that in front of your eyes. Yeah.
It is very important that we celebrate those that are behind the camera as well as in front, because often those in front get the glory, don't they?
Yeah, I mean, actors do tend to elbow their way to the front when it comes to publicity. But anyone who knows anything about television knows that the most important people were honoured tonight. Writers, directors, all the people who make us look good, the creatives, the music, you know, the editors, the sound people. The joy of television is that it's such a huge collaboration.
Yeah.
Without question, it's you've got to honour the people that put it all together and that are the talent behind it.
Totally. And how hard or easy is it to host a job like this?
Well, I don't know really at the moment. I'm a bit shell-shocked. they're a really lovely crowd, actually.
Yeah.
And it's a nice room, nice group number of people, about 550, I think. And I think the thing about evenings like this, everyone's sort of on your side and wants it to be a nice evening. And really my job was just to kind of get things going and then get out of the way and let all those great clips be shown and let people sort of say thank you and have their moment.
Absolutely. And in terms of your own moments, how's everything going? What's coming up next for you?
Yeah, I'm very busy. I've got episodes starting in a few weeks. Then I'm doing a film, and then I'm doing a play. So I'm sort of busy for a while.
Variety of things.
It's just, you know, always what I try and do.
Yeah.
I've done.
Is there any reason for that? Why are you particularly trying?
Well, I think it's healthy for a start. Also, in case I muck up one branch of my career, it's nice to know that the theatre might have me, or if I blow it in theatre, there's still work for me in telly. But it's just interesting. It's very nice when you do stuff, especially I do a lot of comedy.
Mm.
It's very nice occasionally to leave filming behind and say something funny and hear people laugh, which doesn't happen on a film set or on a TV set. So that's why I like going to the theatre and actually just saying something and hear, you know, just that immediate response is great, but it's just to stop me getting bored, really. That's why.
Do you have a particular sort of branch that you feel most at home at, though? Do you think if you had to pick one of those avenues, where would you go?
I don't know. I always wanted to be a theatre actor. That's when I left drama school. I refused to do any film or telly for 5 years because that's all I wanted to do was be on stage.
Wow.
So I think that would probably be my.
What a lot of people normally would jump at the chance to do the opposite.
Yeah, my agent was very supportive. I'm still the same agent as when I left drama school, and I don't think any agents now would let you do that. I think they'd go, well, you can do that, but I won't represent you, and that's a shame. I mean, I was, I think, in my 30s before I did my first filming job, and Keira Knightley will have had a 400-year career by the time she gets to 30, so yes, it is unusual now, but... there we go.
You've explored it. Do you think it's the route that you know, if you...
All you want to do is work with good people.
Yeah.
And you don't care where they are. You just want to work with talented writers, talented directors and talented actors. After a while, you realise that's where the joy is and that's where the satisfaction is. So you just seek them out. And if it's on stage or in front of a camera, to be honest, or in a radio studio, it really doesn't matter.
Yeah. And do you have any advice for any aspiring actors that are kind of coming out of drama school thinking, what's next?
Yeah, blimey. I mean, I don't really. Just be on time, work hard, don't be a dick.